Welcome back to my channel. My name is Rachel. That is the R in the R case stumbling bear, and I am a reader and a writer. And I'm back to do another book review for the self-published science fiction contest, this time for Bloodletting, Aria of the Forgotten by Sean Thomas. And I'm going to put up a picture now. Yeah, well, not a chunker. It's very, very shiny with my ring light, so I'm gonna stick with a photo that's not going to reflect as much. This book primarily follows Ravina Moss, who is a private investigator. She's called in to investigate a suspicious death from the mother of the deceased. And the mother has photos that make her think that the death was suspicious. So Ravina goes to investigate and uncovers a bigger plot afoot, all while dealing with the trauma of her own past. This is a very unique world. There are no humans in this verse. Every species is an alien, different from us, and Thomas does go into the descriptions of all of them. Now, even though they are all different species, I could very much see parallels to current events, how situations are in our modern world, and I don't know if Thomas was meaning to make that such a pointed statement or not. It could also just be my life experience that this is how things equated for me. So we have a planet that has accepted a lot of refugees, and some of these refugees have decided to take over the government. And this has happened over many years, and they have successfully done so, and now they are prejudiced and discriminating against another refugee species that was there before them. So despite everybody being an alien and being different species, and nobody is a human, the setups of society is very familiar to us humans. They have people who live in the suburbs, they have people who live in towns, and they have people who live in the cities and ghettos. And then every dimension of these locations have the same problems that they do in the real world. Maybe that's why I was drawing a lot of parallels, even though we had alien species to different groups here in our human existence. But again, I said that this book is primarily following Ravina Moss, who is a private investigator. We do eventually get a second point of view. I'm totally gonna butcher her name. It's Kalisha, I think. It's definitely one of those sci-fi fantasy kind of names. But she's a young teenager, she's a Bokozian, and the Bokozian species is the one that's being discriminated against. She lives in a ghetto and is navigating the world around her, what she wants to do. And so we get to see her view of everything, especially as she develops into an activist. She was always sort of an activist at the beginning, but she had some other concerns that didn't allow her to fully develop. So then that gives you a slightly different view of the events of what's going on versus just following Ravina. And I guess I forgot to say, Ravina is a species called the Forgotten, which is a combination of the Lycuvia and the Portillion. So she's a bi-species, as you can say. And I thought that was a very interesting concept of you have bi-species and how do they come out that is different, that makes people go, oh, okay, these are who your parents were. And then what traits are more noticeable? It's a very interesting book. I do think after the second time somebody goes, oh, you're forgotten, and she was still surprised by it, that perhaps she was too surprised by it all. From all descriptions, the Forgotten have a very certain look to them, I didn't understand how people might think she was something else or not know what she is, because everybody seems to recognize what she is as soon as they see her. Thomas definitely takes time and care in his world building, crafting it, and layering it, especially like with the political aspects. Like, they talk about the different acts, like we're talking politics here, and you know, different numbers, different political groups, different events, and how they kind of layer on each other. Like, there's something that happens in the history where Kalisha's grandmother lived through it, and so she remembers it. And Kalisha talks about, like, oh, I knew you lived through it, but I didn't understand what it actually had happened. I think that Thomas has done such a great job with the world building that he sometimes goes overboard. He wants to share the information. And you get some moments of info dump where somebody is saying, well, this is my history. But the purpose of that is to kind of give that depth of the world building. I don't think we always needed it. Like the bi-species couple that Ravina met in the Morinock neighborhood, I don't think we needed their story. But you do get the depth of there is a history here. And whereas many times in fantasy books and science fiction books, somebody will be like, this one event happened, it's affected everything, and nothing else has been talked about. Thomas has very intentionally gone away from that one moment. There's not just one moment. There's this moment, and then this moment in history, and this moment in history, and this moment in history. So, and how do they all work around each other? I wouldn't be surprised if Thomas likes politics or follows or works in some way with it, because he does have definitely all of it layered together. And my biggest complaint with his world building is just the moments where we have this info dump, let's talk about something for a long period of time. I also don't think that Thomas needed the prologue. By giving us the prologue, he kind of showed us what was happening. So the reader knows, but Ravina still has to figure it out. I don't think the reader needs to know what is happening. I think if just from reading the story, you can skip the prologue and then find out what's happening with Ravina, and it will be just as impactful and meaningful. We got to a point where the book had basically come to an end and we were just wrapping things up. But no, Thomas then very nicely cliffhangered the book. So the events of the book are wrapped up, but for what's going to happen next, events happen that basically are spurring us into the second book. And I want to know what happened to Ides, what's going to be happening with Ravina, what happened with Kalisha. So I am very interested in continuing with this series. If you have read this book, I would love to know your thoughts down below. Thank you, and have a great day.